Hi folks, James here once again, very warm welcome to you all. Pleased to have brought you along with me today on a lovely late autumn, early winter stroll out on one of my favourite routes. And you find me resting up with pipe and tea, enjoying some peace and quiet and the sounds of the countryside as best as I'm able to. Maybe 2 or 3 miles from home, and as I said before in my videos, one of the few locations where one can really get away from the sort of built-up areas and all the sights and sounds that brings. So I'm lucky to be able to do that, but you're never far away from roads and all the usual trappings of relatively built-up areas. But anyway, pleased to be here again, and and to have brought you out with me. I hope the footage isn't too sort of bleached out. So my camera's very basic, and it is extraordinarily bright today, which is, it's almost dazzling. It's lovely. We've had quite a number of days of, well, short days to get used to, but just a lot of dull, damp and blustery weather. So today is really good to lift the spirit. Hopefully we shall get many more days like this, and I shall feel encouraged to get out and hopefully take you along with me too. Enjoying some lovely tea, which is brewed in Cornwall in the UK, and unremarkably it is called Cornish Tea. This is a Cornish Tea Company. This is not by any way a paid endorsement, but just a recommendation really. This was bought for me to try, and it is a very nice blend that is Zimbabwean and Malawian black teas, so it is delightfully robust and malty, which is what I like in my teas. I do like other sort of types of blends as well, but yeah, a delightful, lovely delightful tea, and paired with a very basic light Virginia tobacco in the pipe, and the two really pair very nicely. If you've viewed my videos before, you'll know that that's my sort of preferred combination. I do like other things as well with the pipe, but a good cup of tea seems to do the trick for me. Yeah, so that's a lovely Cornish tea, and this is especially desirable because it doesn't use any plastics in its tea bags. And of course this means they can be composted without any worry. So yeah, without prolonging this sort of plug too long, there are other teas available, and I do drink lots of other kinds of tea, but that's one I would recommend, and it's one I've been enjoying recently. And as far as the tobacco goes, this is a blend, a very simple blend that I'm going to devote another video to. So I would hope that you would like to perhaps join me for that at some point. So that I shall go into further detail about, but suffice to say at this stage it's something I've been enjoying along with my Cornish tea, yeah, so you'll hear a bit more about that at some point, and hopefully some point soon, because without going into masses of sort of preamble and the usual sort of you know, where have I been, what have I been up to, I'm not going to go into too much detail, but just I've been busy like so many other people, a lot of it hinging on my return to work at a busy boarding school, and I've been back there now for just over 12 months, and it's in a very tiny county, indeed the smallest county in the UK, and it is in Rutland, which is not too far from where I am in Northamptonshire, but yes, it is the smallest county we have. Very delightful it is too, and yeah, so working for a busy boarding school around a busy town, and always just lots to do all year round, yeah, it's taken a great deal of my energies, I've been sort of trying to keep up with my interests as well, and sometimes things have to give, and you know how it goes, but anyway, yeah, so pleased to be back out here, and yeah, it's I've missed filming, so I've enjoyed getting back behind the camera, and you get sort of get your eye in and start noticing things. And I've come out on foot today. I fancied slowing the pace down a bit, and whilst I do love to cycle out on a day like today, thought I'd just set out on foot, and that's been a good choice so far, although it is a little bit claggy and soft in places due to the wet weather we've had, but so yes, most enjoyable. A big thank you and a shout out to somebody very generous who has in the past sent me tobacco, pipe tobacco that is, and has just recently inquired again as to my you know, would I like a bit more, just, you know who you are, thank you very much, it's much appreciated, and especially if you're finding that you know, it's not to your taste or you're not going to make use of it, I'm pleased to be able to enjoy what you're sending. I've had some aromatic, which actually I found quite refreshing for a change. That was nice in the summer, Still got a bit of that left. I believe there may be some Bob's chocolate flake and another sort of festive aromatic as well on the way. So once again, my sincere thanks. That's most kind of you. Yeah, I shall look forward to enjoying that. So, still been, as I say, enjoying my pipe. Moderately, I would say, and the usual sort of blends. I'm hearing all sorts of things in the background. I think it's either deer or pheasant or possibly a dog walker. But yeah, my location is just literally beside a public footpath. I've sort of come out of a plateau of mixed woodland out onto the side of the valley, where it becomes sort of open arable field, and there is sort of a copse behind me here, and there you can hear all sorts in there. Normally I find that generally the pheasants seem to pop up in the videos I make this time of year normally, but so far, actually, there's not been that many. The Brampton Woods, which is just up the way, is a private woodland. Unfortunately, I've said this before, it is basically used for rearing fowl, and I think I did hear it. Have heard some sort of gunshot as I've been out here today, but it is that sort of time of year, and it is set up as a sort of a grid with the sort of woodland forestry avenues with spotting platforms here and there. So it is sort of set up, sort of purpose made really. But nonetheless, the surrounding area is delightful, and I can carry on along the path here, and it takes me right across sort of open land really, and one or two small lanes for quite some way, so it's very pleasant. Back in the summer, I was at a vintage and retro music festival in Bedfordshire, at a place called Twinwood, and you meet all kinds of interesting folk, and I actually met a subscriber, which is quite unusual for me, and rather strange, but it was a brief meeting, but a very interesting young chap. I believe his name is Jake. Hello to you if you're watching, and it was lovely to meet you. Had quite a bit in common, which is nice, and he was enjoying some nice tobacco in his pipe, and interesting young chap, and that was a splendid weekend. As we usually find, and but as I say, quite more or less pretty much unheard of for me to meet another pipe smoker and also a subscriber in the wild, as it were. So yeah, that's quite an odd but enjoyable situation. But, yeah, so as is usual, you will find this to be just really quite a gentle amble with me really going on about not a lot at all really, only really just as a minor catch up, and really the enjoyment of having a bit of time as well. Well, I've made time, which you have to do. So it's very easy just to go through weekends and sort of periods of spare time, and just literally it goes so quickly, as you know. And so yeah, I made it my mission to find a bit of spare time today. And now I'm out, I certainly shan't be rushing. And it is pretty chilly to be lingering today, so I'm well wrapped up. And whilst you're moving, it's very, very pleasant to be out. I come out sort of reasonably early, and I should be back for a well-earned lunch and a warm by the fire. And I shall look forward to putting together what you're viewing now, and I might add that when people contact me, and they have done here and there, it's very inspiring actually to get back and sort of contribute to the channel again. And I suppose really, I'd say, well, thanks very much for that. And if anybody has subscribed recently, many thanks. And if you're viewing for the first time, warmest greetings. Yeah, I do appreciate, you viewing and dropping in to listen to my ramble now and again. And as I always say, hopefully it won't be too long before I return and do something else. But the appetite is well whetted. And I have plenty of ideas for some more uploads. So I think with that, I shall wish you all the best, and I'll see you again soon, hopefully on another one. So cheerio for now.